What up, guys? Today we're gonna be changing out the side mirror of this bad boy. We're gonna be installing the Sumo Performance convex mirrors. It does have integrated turn signals, which is dope, and it also has defrosting technology, so you can still keep your defrosters. Now, if you guys didn't know what a convex mirror is, let me kind of show you. It's tinted blue. This will help reduce any glaring from, you know, trucks that are very lifted with HIDs or LEDs that blind you. The blue really helps cut down that glare. And then the convex shape means you'll see more. Maybe I can show you a quick comparison of that right now. So as an example, we're gonna kind of loom it in a little bit. You can kind of see, that's what you kind of see. And then this is gonna, it's gonna be a little sticking out, but a good comparison is right there. You see how you see more? And this will definitely help you a lot because you can see way more and less blind spots. To install something like this, it's actually quite easy. What you can do is just get some kind of prying tool. This is all you need. You can even use your hands if you want. So let's get it so we have this thing kind of sticking out. That way we can pry. Now I'm just gonna use the motors to. The easiest for me is having it all the way down. When you have it all the way down, you're gonna have it able to pry it a lot easier. You can actually use your hands or a tool. Generally using your hands, you can get a better feel, but you wanna be careful. Let me show you the back of how these tabs actually look. So this is how it looks like in the back, and it's just held by clips. And they're just clipped in. And if it's kind of too hard, kind of help it out and move it up a little bit. It is a tight fit. So I have to move it up a little bit more. And there's several clips and plugs. So the defroster and the auto dimming mirrors. So this is how it looks. The back of the OEM unit right here. This is a heater element, and this is the auto dimming functionality. We don't need this auto dim anymore, and you're not gonna have any codes throw because we're pretty much gonna have it stop glare all the time. This is gonna really come in. Some people also say that the auto dimming doesn't work when you tint your windows. So having it like this all the time is a good thing. And you can see from the back of here, we have turn signal capability. If you wanna keep your turn signals, that is an option. And then you have these little tabs right here for the defrosting. Now, you're gonna basically reuse any of these plugs will work. So it doesn't matter which side is which side. You just plug it to the back of this. But for my case, I noticed that when, I don't know if this is making sense, but these two little tabs, they kind of stick too far out. What you're gonna have to do is actually bend these, or maybe the newer ones are gonna have it so it's angled down. Kind of like the these ones, how they're angled down. That way you have more clearance. This one won't give you enough clearance. So I'm gonna bend them real quick. That way we still keep that defrosting capability. So on my unit, these defrosters were pointed straight out. I gave it a quick bend. You guys can see the little bend I did. That way I'm not gonna have any clearance issue. And as far as these turn signals, I'm not gonna wire them because though it's great if you wanna wire them, it's just a lot of work. And it's a lot of work. Real quick. And you just snap it on. So we got both of the defrosters in. Get you guys a good look at that. And because it's angled at that, it shouldn't affect the any clearance issue running into here. Perhaps tuck these wires in nice and tightly. And you just give it a good push. Fingerprints all over this bad boy. And that concludes the tutorial. We have the mirror's end. Do the same for this other side, and you're gonna be golden.